Welcome to my channel, detailing events throughout the decades. 1930, R101 Airship Crash. Back in the day, airships were the holy grail of international air travel. The British government was eager to join the Imperial Airship Scheme in 1924, funding competition between Air Ministry Team R101, and the Vickers Company R100. The brief called for airships to be bigger than previously constructed. It needed to be capable of lifting 5 fighter aircraft or 200 soldiers with their equipment. R101 began construction in 1926. On completion in 1929, the R101 was the largest man-made object ever to fly. It had many innovative design features, these however caused a delay in the completion date. The airship suffered from design flaws due to meddling by Air Ministry committee members, who would change the specifications often. In the winter of 1929, the R101 was brought back to the hangar and cut in half. Another gas bag was inserted to give her more lift. She was very lavish inside. She boasted 2 decks, with a dining room which could seat 60 people, as well as a smoking room, which seated 20 people. Walls inside were made of doped linen, painted in gold and white. Weight-saving measures were in place. These included wicker furniture and aluminium cutlery. Promenade windows were lightweight celluloid instead of glass. Airships were seen as luxury travel, and often compared to luxury ocean liners. The R101 took to the sky in October 1929. The airship made an appearance at the Hendon Air Show in 1930. She was hastily readied for her maiden voyage. On the evening of October 4, 1930, the R101 departed for India, with a refueling stop scheduled in Egypt. It was a misty and dark evening when she finally departed. She was fully loaded with fuel. In normal service, the airship would have 42 crew on board. The airship departed from Cardington, and was intended to travel to Karachi. The airship cast off at 6:36 in the evening, with cheers from crowds on onlookers. At just after 7 in the evening, the duty engineer reported an oil pressure problem. Diesel engines had been specified by the Air Ministry as the airship was intended for use on the India route. Temperatures there would make petrol engines unacceptable. At 9:35, the airship crossed the English coast near Hastings. Weather had now started to deteriorate. By 10:56 the winds had risen to 44 miles per hour. The airship was observed flying at low altitude no further than northern France. The airship went into a slow dive and hit the ground. The airship exploded instantly, with fire so intense that it lasted for 24 hours. It was thought that the airship was attempting to make an emergency landing, after a gas bag was punctured. Only 8 of the 54 passengers and crew survived the crash. The bodies of those who perished were returned back to England. On Friday, October 10, a memorial service took place at St. Paul's Cathedral, while the bodies lay in state at Westminster Hall. Nearly 90,000 people queued to pay their respects. The inquiry into the crash examined most aspects of the design and construction of the airship in detail. Particular emphasis was made on the gas bags and the associated harnessing and valves. An examination was also made of the various operational decisions that had been made before the airship undertook its final voyage. A sudden and catastrophic failure was seen as the only explanation into the crash. The R101 was the end of British attempts to create lighter-than-air aircraft in the pre-war period. On October 1, 1933, a memorial to those who perished was unveiled near the crash site. On November 27, 2014, 84 years after the crash, Baroness Smith of Basildon, along with the members of the Airship Heritage Trust, unveiled a memorial plaque to the airship in St. Stephen's Hall at the Palace of Westminster. Thank you for watching and learning about events throughout history. Forever remembering those who perished on that fatal day.